for the last title available here throughout the day.
And let's welcome the players on to court. First up, please make some noise for the number 4 seeds from Denmark, Niclas and Sara.
And here they are. We've just had, some moments ago, some Danish success here in the men's doubles. These pair that have just made their way onto the main court will be looking to back that up and make it a Danish 1-2. We started out with 18 Danish players here in the draw on Wednesday. It's good to see that Danish players have made it through to the final here on Sunday. Has almost been raised, lifted off here inside the Emirates Arena, and that means only one thing. The number one seed and defending champions, Imogen Bankier and Robert Blair, have made their way here to defend their title here in the mixed doubles final. The supporters have paid good money here to witness some fantastic badminton throughout the day here on Sunday. And without being disrespectful to some of the other players here in the finals, it is these two, the Scottish pair, the number one seeds that they've come to see successfully, they hope, defend their title. Well, once again, it's Errol Creary, myself and Gail Emms behind the microphone here inside the commentary booth. And Gail, the big question is, disappointment for Imogen Bankier yesterday. Can she put the record straight here today with her usual partner in crime, Robert Blair?
I can't wait for this final. I know I'm biased in the fact that I used to play mixed doubles, but I love watching Imogen Bankier play. She's such a talented player. And Robert Blair, I know, I used to train with him lots of times. We went to Athens Olympics together. He was in the GB squad then. I think he's incredible. And Judy Murray has been such a fan of Imogen and Rob. She's been there to support them in the Commonwealth Games here in Glasgow earlier on this year in the summer. So she loves her badminton. She's here to support them as well. Imogen and Rob really have flown the flag for Scottish badminton recently. They've done so well and they've worked really hard together. So I'm really, in a biased way, because I've worked with the two players a lot and I've played with them for many years, I would love them to win on home soil.
Well, the umpires and service judges have been working hard all week, and a Swedish umpire, last but not least, in the chair, Jan Andersson, backed up by the service judge from Switzerland, Daniel Schmidt, overseeing proceedings here for this, the last title up for grabs here in Glasgow. Now, 18 Danish players started out on Wednesday here, 36 from Scotland. These two, they're so established, they're so illustrious. It's good to see them back here once again to defend their title, Blair and Bankier. Here's their road to the final, the number one seed and defending champion. No problems at all against Clare and Minnis of England in round one, again against the Canadian duo in round two. Quarter-final against the French pair, Fontaine and Mittelheim. So, well, a touch of turbulence on the way, and there certainly was in the semi-final, dropping the first game against Kasbauer and Hertridge of Germany, Gale. A slow, sluggish start out the block. They can't do that today.
You're right. They were complacent in the first set, and I didn't like watching that because I know, yes, they are the number one seed. Yes, they are expected to win this tournament, and they were expected to win that semi-final pretty comfortably. But there was a casualness about it that you can't do, because this tournament, every player here wants to win this. And as soon as they see their opponent take their foot off the pedal, they're in there like a flash, seizing their chance. So for me, it was I was glad to see them get back on track and get through to the final.
Well, again, like it is for the Scottish pair, as it is for the Danish pair, just one game has been dropped. Round one, no problems at all against the French duo of Chenet and Constantine. Again, against the Dutch pair, round two, the same against the Canadians. And just yesterday in the semi-final against Nelte and Scherwenger of Germany. Well, it was rocky, but in the end, they made it through to the final to fight out for the title here. It's going to be a tough ask for the Danish pair. They'll have the crowd on their side, Blair and Bankier. They'll need to utilise that. They did it in the Commonwealth Games, of course. They got themselves a medal.
A bronze it was. They did it this time last year where they delighted the public here winning that title. Well, here they are, 33 years of age, Robert Blair. 27 last week, Imogen Bankier. Perhaps a belated birthday present it would be if you were to win the title after a disappointing women's doubles campaign yesterday with Kirsty Gilmour. No prizes or guesses as to who that round of applause was for. Without further ado, mixed doubles final here in Glasgow, up and underway.
Doubles is so tactical. It's all about trying to open the space, get the girl at the back of the court, out of her favorite position at the net. No niceties in this game. It's all about trying to outwit your opponents. And a lot of the attack is pinpointed at the female player. These guys will smash about 200 miles an hour, and they will target the girls.
Good to see so many people associated with Scottish badminton make their way into their seats inside the Emirates Arena. A lot of hard work behind the scenes has gone to give people here in Scotland a platform to showcase their skills. £113 million here spent on the Emirates Arena, and it is money very well spent.
2-3.
The Scottish pair of Bankier and Blair, who have the psychological edge going into today's final. 2-0. First meeting was in 2013 at the Yonex Belgium International. 21-13, 19-21, 21-18. They met again this year at the French International. Much more simplistic this time. 21-12, 21-14. With that in mind, they'll need to get off to a good start today, the Danish couple.
Yeah, and this is the first time I've seen them play. I've heard about the pair, I've heard good things about the pair. Very talented. He's a left-handed player. She's got very good touch. Sara's got great touch around the net. So I'm intrigued how they're going to cope with the final, the pressure of playing against the favorites, pair that are in their home crowd and all the support.
His right-hand side at one stage.
4-5.
Yeah, really, really intense rally there. Was confusion from the Danes. They got back into it. Confusion from the Scots. And it was an unforced error from Niclas, just giving the Scottish a point.
5-4.
Scottish as well as Danish players have dominated in the last 3 years in the mixed doubles. Of course, Blair and Bankier winning last year, 2011. Astrup Sorensen as well as Alina Kaesfeld, victorious in the mixed doubles. Inspired to be well again, Dale. Top through.
6-5.
Yeah.
Imogen was crossing two lines there. She should have gone straight down the line, just blocked off, but she tried to do a clever top spin shot, really associated with tennis, but it didn't come off and that went well out of the back of the court.
7-6.
Yeah, good flick serve from Niclas N.NOHR.
Being waved in the crowd at the end of this match. If it will be doing so
seven,
again.
Eight.
Yeah, Bankier and Blair have got to be patient. The errors will come, particularly from N.NOHR. He's an erratic player, but they can't. Yeah, like I said, they've got to be patient.
It's over.
Sara Thygesen
9-7.
Is doing really well to try and take charge of this final match.
Good effort.
10-7.
Yeah, N.NOHR has got a great technique with that left-handed style of play that he's got. He reaches up, it's so disguised, and when you're diagonally cross from the man where the girl stands in defense, it can be very daunting because you have to guess which way the man is going to hit, so he can hit the slice drop, he can hit the smash, he could even punch clear. Imogen was caught off guard with the slice.
11-7, interval.
Well, there's the first interval. It's not going the way of the public here in Glasgow. Good start here made by the number four seeds. Titles already so far in the mixed doubles this year for N.NOHR and Thygesen. Victor Dutch International as well as the Victor Croatian International. Well, they've got the crowd against them, girl. They're up against the number one season defending champions, but settled down very early into a nice pattern of play so far.
I think you hit that right on the head. They've got lovely patterns of play, and Imogen and Rob are falling into those patterns. Sara is very good coming off the net and just placing the shuttle back down cross court, getting the lift for Niclas, who's producing great angles and variety with his style of play. Imogen and Rob are always on the back foot. Imogen's trying to get into the net. She's trying to come in off the smash shots and the drop shots and trying to play the net. But it's just not working at the moment.
Seven.
The Danish pair look faster. Play. They look more efficient at the moment, and they look like they could go even faster still.
Service over.
Used your ears now by another point. Blair and Bankier. 9 titles as a doubles partnership in their time. Scottish Open Championships here in 2007. Last year, of course, 4 titles this year. This year's Commonwealth Games. They didn't panic at all yesterday, despite the fact they dropped the opening game.
Eight.
Blair and Bankier doing well to stay in that rally, but when Sara Thygesen cut that shot out at the net, it was just too much for Blair. Couldn't get his wrist and his racket around that shuttle to keep that in court. Good play from Imogen Bankier. She's done that twice now. She's tried to push really hard at the body of Sara Thygesen. She's very good at coming off the net if you don't put pace on it. But just by putting an extra little bit on, it's just putting her in a bit of trouble. Imogen has to take control of the net if she wants to be a big influence in this game.
That's where excellent coaching comes to the table. Been a good reaction from the first interval. One solitary point, they're different now. Oh, that's smart. And Blair, he appreciated that. He's given it a clap and completely wrong footing. The 33-year-old from Edinburgh. Bedded down his roots here in this very city of Glasgow now. Imogen Bankier, born and raised here. Father on the board, of course, at Celtic.
Never going to land out. They're on the slow side. The shuttle is going to drop short. And any other haul that would have flown out, but Robert just lost his bearings a little bit.
Just a touch of indecision there from Niclas N.NOHR. One sees, won't mind that at all, won't take anything. All square. They're on terms here, Blair and Bankier.
Then getting Sara Thygesen at the back of the court. So that's where you need to expose the weakness. Their favourite position is Sara at the net and Niclas at the rear of the court.
Well, it was this stage last year in the final for Blair and Bankier where they found that extra level. Won it, beating the English pair, Chris Lambridge and Heather Oliver, 21-16, 21-14. Picked it up at this stage. We're in the arrears now, they're 1 point clear.
Thygesen really started this match so confident. She was moving around. But she's just falling into the hands of Imogen Bankier now. Again, let it go, Blair. Well, it was bad smash from Imogen Bankier. She smashed it straight onto Sara Thygesen's forehand. She was committed to that forehand. She used her body, she got her body right round, and she made sure she could get that shuttle straight down the line. So it was bad placement from Imogen. Was she moving really fast around the court, but she turned that shuttle away from the Danish pair. So clever. And here when Sara Thygesen tried to do a loopy net shot, it was too much, and Bankier instantly reacted and just pushed that body into that shuttle into her body. Much better from the Scottish. They are hitting the shuttle in the gaps over Sara Thygesen's head, making Niclas N.NOHR move around that court so much more. He's had to work really, really hard there. And instead of playing into the hands of Sara Thygesen, she was very good at anticipating where the Scottish pair were playing. Now it's the other way around.
Clear points. Such a breathing space here for the number one seeds. It's ranking of 19, career high of 10. Ascendancy they are, getting closer to the finishing line. 17 minutes have gone so far in the last final of the day. Well, she needed that, Thygesen.
Yes, she did. That would give us so much confidence. 90. Poor shot from Blair. It was punished by Thygesen. He tried to loop it over her head, but she read it, got her body there, was able to cut that smash cross court, cross Robert Blair's body.
But the omens are good for the Scottish pair. They've yet to lose a final as a pair so far in 2014. So solid so far. Disappointment for her yesterday, losing the women's doubles semi-final. But she wants to go ahead, get the prize here today on Sunday, one day later. Here it is, the number one seeds have themselves their first game point. In it, the Danish pair. 18-20. So there's two game points. This time it is the number four seeds who have the serve. Oh.
run out this time. So high five from Blair and Bankier. The job is halfway done here for the defending champions and number one seed. First game on the board, 3 points the difference, 21 points to 18.
Well, there was signs of complacency in that first half of that game from the Scots, but they stepped it up when it mattered. They were down at the interval by 3 points. And suddenly, Imogen Bankier got that confidence to go for the net. She took on Sara Thygesen and was the better out of the girls in the end. It is a battle out there. It's a battle which guy is going to be the best, who's going to be the alpha male. And with the girls, it's going to be who's going to be the queen bee on that court. That's how mixed doubles is played. And it is a battle not only as a partnership, but against your opposite number. So for me, I always had to try and get the initiative against the girls who I was playing with. If it was staring them over the net, or just a little sly little look, or just trying to take the shuttle so early and be that dominant one. Because you've not only got to contend with the guy hitting 200 miles an hour smashes at you, you've got to contend with a girl trying to do that to you as well. But it's been really, really good to watch. I'm loving this match, and I love the tactics of it. I love the fact that the Danes are really trying to twist Robert Blair and move him all around the court. And I also love the fact that the Scots are doing exactly the same to Niclas N.NOHR. They're saying, well, if you're going to do that to us, we're going to do it to you. Pushing Sara Thygesen at the back. She is not strong at the back of the court, whereas Imogen Bankier is a lot more comfortable from her ladies' doubles. Sara Thygesen's not. She looks stressed when she's at the court. She wants to run straight back in to the net area.
Well, his first back through the court of action is Niclas N.NOHR. 3 points, the margins are very, very tight in that first game. 21-18 for Blair and Bankier. They make such a fantastic mixed doubles pair, they really do. 33 years of age now, Blair. You wonder, perhaps this could be swan song if they go ahead to win here again.
That is the golden question.
We've highlighted the fact on a couple of occasions, Thygesen, she's been pinpointed, she's been targeted, needs to do something about it and get a reaction somehow, some way.
Tell you when things are not going well as the female player in a mixed doubles partnership, when you're being targeted and you can't get back into the game, that court can feel like the worst place in the world. Great serve from Imogen Bankier. Niclas N.NOHR, he's staring at Imogen Bankier when he receives serve, and she has the audacity to hold it, and then last minute just turn it cross court.
Blair. Once their tails are up, very hard to stop the express train that goes by the name of Robert Blair and Imogen Bankier. Seen that time and time again over the last few seasons. There it is again. What a start made in game number two. It is an unblemished start. Five, and seven five. Defeats so far in their season.
whatever happens out there today. Win or lose, the season's not over for Blair and Bankier. They are to be selected for the team, the all-star European team, in fact, to take part in the Exeter Cup 2014 in Kuala Lumpur. It's going from November the 27th, in procession until December the 7th. In fact, Singapore, the Philippines, Indonesia, Malaysia, All-Star Europe, all taking part. The richest event in badminton. Third year of the event, with last year's event being witnessed by a staggering 240 million viewers. Jonas Blair and Bankier, Kirsty Gilmour as well, will be in that side.
Imogen Bankier shakes her head. Such a great rally, both pairs. Fantastic in defence and attack, and Imogen Bankier so confident at the rear of the court, just slice that shuttle into the net. No need to do that. There was no one there threatening.
Stop the rock. 5-0, 5-3, and now another point. The lead is back. 3 points. Excellent response by the Danish pair. Didn't push the panic button at all. Five down, it's the second game. We had to cover a lot of ground there in that last rally, Niclas Norgay, and in the end, just a bridge too far.
Yeah, and he's looking up at the lights. I think he lost that shuttle. These lights are so bright. It's great that we can have TV lights here to showcase the court, and it makes it a great atmosphere for the spectators. But sometimes when that shuttle goes up, it is so bright, you will lose that shuttle. Another battle of the net won by Imogen Bankier. Simple net shot from Sara Thygesen, goes into the net. She could see Imogen Bankier advancing towards her, just put that pressure on her to. So her shot had to be perfect. In the end, she put it into the net. Did Imogen Bankier win that rally? She managed to pick that shuttle from somewhere. The defence right out of, right behind her, came in and attacked, won the point.
Impressive thing was as well, so easy on the either shot, but so quickly on the front foot to get to the net.
On. My initial reaction was it was out, very only just. I'm sure we can see it from this angle, but I'm pretty sure the line judge got that right.
This angle will definitely give us better indication. Yeah. Good call.
She's more disappointed with herself. Taking it out on the line call.
Oh, disappointment again for the Danish duo. It is onwards and upwards as we speak here for Blair and Bankier. One game on the board already, and at the first interval in game number two, we have a very healthy lead. 5 points the difference, and all to do for the number four seeds to turn this around. They've got the crowd against them. They're up against the defending champions and number one seeds, Gail. The coach here that you know well has to do a lot of talking.
He does have to do a lot of talking, Kenneth Jonasson. Even though he's a singles player, naturally, he's an incredible coach. He's an incredible inspiration and a role model for these young badminton players. To have someone of his calibre to come on and chat to them, to talk them through their game, would be so powerful to these athletes, to Sara and Niclas. He will have that experience, and he will just be telling them just to just refine the little points that they're not quite doing right at the moment, but most of all just telling them just to keep going, just really try and motivate them.
There he is, just giving some encouragement once again to his team. That's the best possible start. Beautiful technique.
Beautiful technique and great skill to do this shot. Lovely block from Imogen Bankier. The pace was, Imogen Bankier had taken the pace off. So Sara Thygesen had to create a shot, and she did that magnificently. Scottish are really pumped up now. They can see the end in sight. Great set play from Imogen Bankier. She used the first three shots so well. She used her experience. She and Sara Thygesen played into Imogen's hands there. Lovely cross-court backhand net shot.
Late surge from the Danish pair. It's going to come to the court of play. It needs to start now. Oh, that was close. Very, very close.
Robert Blair just giving a quizzical look. Yeah, that was out. From the Scots. And targeting Sara. She dealt with it. Pop shot over her head to Niclas, but he was very aware of Imogen Bankier running in to try and intercept his drop shot.
Yes! Serve is over. 10-16.
Catching the Scottish player by surprise.
This is the perfect return. That's what you aim for every time. That net cord, so it just drops over the net.
Over.
Wow, Robert can do it too.
Not to be outdone by the number four seeds.
17-10.
Nice of luck, Robert Blair, of course. Nice touch of sportsmanship, just raising up his arm. 7 points now, the difference getting closer and closer here to once again being crowned champions. Smiles on the faces of the supporters here inside the Emirates Arena. Waiting with bated breath perhaps to see the number one seeds will win here again. And some wonderful role models in Scottish badminton over the last few years. And of course, Blair and Bankier, they're up there with them.
Again from the Scottish pair, they're creeping up the court.
19-11.
Well, they have themselves perhaps an unassailable lead here. A game on the board, 19 points to 11 now in the second, and on serve. Well, that is fantastic reaction. She's been absolutely delightful to watch today, Imogen Bankier. Well, it's taken only 36 minutes of play to earn themselves their first championship point. Well, a hush descends around the Emirates Arena here. That's a championship point saved by the number four seeds. Waiting here. It ain't over until it's over, as they say. Oh, what a conundrum. We saw Wang of Chinese Taipei have four championship points disappear. Still plenty on the board here for Blair and Bankier. Taking this time, and it's come from the strings of Robert Blair. Champions once again, Bankier and Blair. They've successfully defended their title, and they've done it in 37 minutes. 21-18, much more simplistic in the second game. 21-14, for the third time in three meetings, they've defeated the number four seeds of Denmark, Sara Thygesen and Niclas N.NOHR. Well, they've delighted the public here inside the Emirates Arena, and it has been a wonderful turnout, a good attendance. And they're the champions once again, the first pair to successfully defend a title here in Glasgow this millennium. Fantastic achievement, and interesting to hear exactly what they have to say with Gail Emms down courtside.
Sara, Niclas, unlucky in that final. You were up against a very good pair in Robert and Imogen.
Sorry?
You were playing a very good pair with Robert and Imogen. Unlucky.
Yeah, they played really well. We didn't manage to keep our game quite as well as we thought we could. Yeah.
You had a great start in the first set, though. The confidence was high. You were looking really good.
Yeah, I think we played really, really well in the start, but But I think they moved into the game really well, and we didn't manage to move forward in the court and got too much in the defensive, and the second set wasn't that good. So that's the right winner, and I think they played a really good game today.
I know you're very disappointed now, but the crowd really enjoyed watching that mixed doubles. Going to learn a lot from that?
Yeah, it's real nice to be here. It's the first time here in Glasgow. It's real nice crowd, and it's a big pleasure to play in front of so many people.
Well, congratulations to getting to the final. Please show your appreciation for Niclas and Sara. We have the winners of 2014 Scottish Open Grand Prix, Imogen Bankier, Robert Blair. How good does it feel to retain the title?
Yeah, it feels absolutely fantastic to come out again in the Emirates Arena after the Commonwealth Games. It's a really special place for us and holds great memories, so happy to win in front of our home crowd who are great today in supporting us.
Great crowds here today, great support. You had that in the summer at the Commonwealth Games, you got the bronze medal. How does it feel to be back in this Emirates Arena?
Well, I think only had good luck here after winning last year and then doing well in the Commonwealth and come back here. And as Imogen says, when you do well at some place, it's just so nice to be back. And the fact that it's on our doorstep and our family and friends and all the local people to come and watch just makes it so much more special.
Well, I have to put you on the spot here, Robert. Are we going to see you here again next year?
I'll see how my legs are moving. They're getting a little slower each year, but I might have a little bit more left in me.
Do you want him to carry on for a little bit longer, Imogen? You look so good on that court. We love watching you play together.
Of course, we love playing together, and he is a bit of a legend, old Bob, so we want him to keep going as long as possible, so it'll be good to see him for another year.
Well, I think the crowd here want to see you carrying on playing. Please show your appreciation to the 2014 Scottish Open mixed doubles winners, Robert Blair and Imogen Bankier.
That is just about it for business here in Glasgow. And here are the results for the day here. The final day, of course, on Sunday, started off with the women's singles final, won by the unseeded Japanese player Sato, beating Corrales of Spain, the number two seeds in straight games, as well as Stueva sisters 2-0 against Olver and Smith of England. Villa Lang, the winner here again, as he was in 2006, 2-1 against Wang of Chinese Taipei. We did see some victories here for the Danish contingent. It was the men's doubles final won by Christiansen and Daugaard. Straight games against the German pair Beck and Hines. And just some moments ago, we've seen the successful defensive win again of Bankier as well as Blair, backing up what they did in 2013, winning in style here in Glasgow in their home arena against the Danish pair of N.NOHR and Thygesen.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for the presentations for the mixed doubles final. Please welcome the players back into the arena.
For the very last time, we see the victorious couple, as well as the runner-ups, being led out onto the court by this wonderful pipe band. It's been an honour to witness them today. Champions being led out, of course. Blair and Bankier, the champions, and of course the pipe band were champions of their own, of course, the European champions, and as well second in the World Pipe Band Championships here in Glasgow. The crowd have enjoyed badminton, the highest order so far today, good to see the Scottish flags being proudly waved in the crowd here today. A disappointment yesterday for Imogen Bankier. She just swept that under the carpet today. Set the record straight, and here she is once again. Champions with a wonderful doubles partner, Robert Blair. Their 10th title together and their 5th in 2014. Undefeated once they have reached the final this year. And credit where credit is due to them for that achievement.
Let's hear it one more time for our runners-up from Denmark, Niclas and Sara Tigerson. And let's raise the roof for our winners from Scotland, Robert Blair and Imogen Bankier.
It is for Robert Blair and Imogen Bankier, champions again, defending their title they won last year. The third time Robert Blair has stood on the winner's podium here in Glasgow. He did it all the way back in 2001, where he represented England, in fact, with Natalie Munt. Here he is, 2014, as we've rolled the clock forward with a wonderful doubles partner in the form of Imogen Bankier. Certainly hope to see him back once again as a 34-year-old to defend his title. Perhaps, or even one better, and make it a hat-trick of title wins. Commiserations to Niclas N.NOHR and Sara Thygesen. They have won 2 titles so far this year, but unfortunately couldn't have enough match craft to get it over the line to defeat the number one seeds. And flames are plenty here inside the Emirates Arena. What a way to end proceedings here for the day in Glasgow. The Emirates Arena over the last 12 months has witnessed some fantastic badminton here today, and of course in the Commonwealth Games early on in the year. Well, we brought the curtain down on a fantastic day of action, Gate. Another instalment successfully here from the Scottish Open Grand Prix. What a day of action.
It's been fantastic, and what an end to the action. That mixed doubles final was brilliant and such a crowd pleaser. To have Robert Blair and Imogen Bankier up there on the podium with the trophy, I couldn't think of a more fitting end to it. Such a brilliant tournament.
I endorse that absolutely. Absolutely, 100%. It has been an absolute pleasure. Myself, Errol Creary, to be together in the company of Gail M's MBE for semi-finals day and here today in the final. Many thanks for tuning into our coverage. It has been a pleasure as well. And it is a very good afternoon and goodbye for now here from the Emirates Arena in Glasgow.